So instead, I'm gonna start this. When I mean start, I mean continue. Like I said, I'm done with Apex for now. Not after that last match, anyway. That last match was utter devastation. And I finished episode 3, didn't I? Yeah, I did. Oh, frame rate. Also, if this game crashes again, I'm gonna cry. But yeah, so instead, Dan, you get to sit back, relax, and watch some Lego Star Wars. If you give a shit, of course. I would ask, but have you ever played this game, Daniel? If you say no, I'm gonna cry. Also, never mind. Also, I'm not wearing a Star Wars t-shirt. Oh well. Then again, today's not May 4th. Yeehaw. Did I say something there? Volume was on low. Thanks, man. No, that should be better. But I was just gonna say, have you ever played this? You haven't played the Indiana Jones Lego game though? Oh. I mean, Lego Indiana Jones is pretty good. Lego Indiana Jones 2 is not, however. That game is poo-poo. And no, I will not be binge playing the entire Lego series. Because 100%ing LEGO games back to back would be extremely boring and monotonous. And that also reminds me, when I continue playing this tomorrow, I don't need to. I think this is a big if. Okay, never mind, I can't find it. But I do have the strategy guide for this. I normally have all my stuff in one pile. Look at all, Daniel. Yeah, like I said, I normally have all my stuff in one pile. Thanks for no studs. Oh, come on. There we go. That's one way to do it, I suppose. Oh yeah, bollocks, I've got to pick up 3PR, haven't I? Oh, nice underwear. Thanks, game. Also, I think this is the best one. Just some stormtroopers casually swimming. Well, not swimming, but bathing. Ah, Tatooine. Again. So this time we gotta meet some Jawas. Or Jawas, however you wanna pronounce it. Yeah, I should be able to get through the last three films. And like I say, tomorrow it's just cleaning up and getting 100%. Spoiler alert for anyone who didn't know, Ben Kenobi. Thanks, game. Also, I'm pretty certain this level sucks for getting studs on. Oh, hey. I'll just say Pokemon Trainer. That'll make the most sense. Oh. Thanks. Oh, you are? Nice. I hope you enjoy your time here. It's an alright place to be. Now, can I cheat the system? No, I can't, number one. Hopefully the first of many. If I remember correctly, if I push it backwards, there's a mini kit. Nope. I'm just lying. Banta. You idiot. Is that going to turn out? That's fine. You do you. Oh yeah, this sucks because these guys will attack me. I don't know what I'm doing. I can't get it on this level. I mean, you can, but that means running around like a pillock for about 10 minutes. Oh! I think the first bloody red brick that I want to get is fast build. Okay, I completely cheated the system there. Oh, I'll even cheat the system on that one then. I believe you're not meant to actually get, you're not meant to get it that way. Okay, no idea what the hell that's for. Are you really stuck, Luke? You idiot. Now you're morphing. Doesn't he pull out a duck? No, never mind. I thought he did. Well, at least C-3PO's dead. Bye, R2. Oh yeah, I love all these low res images. Oh, bless me. Excuse me. Oh, piss off. Damn it. Well, see ya, Jawa. Asshole. Why? I'm not gonna ask. Only question is, how would you even know if I have one? That's the question. Because if I don't have one, I probably do, but maybe I don't. Who knows? Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Yeah, I know. I know there's one there. It's just like, you never know. Someone might waltz in and go, I want this. I don't have one. Make one. I don't really need one. Fuck you. It's like, okay, dude, calm down. But considering no one ever scrolls down, Okay, I somehow died in one hit, lovely. Also, we are now vandals. Rest in peace, Peter Mayhew. Also, I do like his little grin that he gives. Just a... Oh, hey, Black Blazer. How you doing? How's my day? I mean, it's fine. Going about as well as any other day, really. How was your day? I'd ask Black Blazer, but he'd just sit there and go, "Fuck you." You're not that mean. Well, no, you're not, but as we've discussed before, you never really type if you're going well or not, so I'd say. I know I still ask it on occasion, but I don't really ask you anymore. It's not that I don't care. It's just that I know when people... No means no. Is going great. Nice. I won't mind playing some Pokemon games though. Because, I mean, obviously, your name is Pokemon, but Wait a minute, isn't R2 behind this bloody door? No, he isn't. Like I say, I won't mind playing Pokemon. Only problem is I don't really have a way of streaming it. I know I can buy one and then emulate it, but... Oh, heck, I don't know. Does Discord count as social media? I mean, yeah, because it's a social, it's a place where people gather, so it's a social location. So yeah, I'd say yeah. Excuse me. Walking on. You can see the live action detective Pikachu movie. If you want. It's gonna be terrible, but. Where the hell am I going? I mean, it's probably gonna be terrible, but. Hey, who am I to judge, eh? You're a big Pokemon fan. I don't mind Pokemon. You know, especially just, you know, the video games on DS. I don't mind them. I mean, they're pretty good. But, yeah, I've mentioned this before, but, like, as soon as I started watching Yu-Gi-Oh, I dropped Pokemon. I did. I really didn't care for Pokemon anymore. You'll take that over what they're doing with Sanic. I mean, true. I mean, I can't argue that. I can't. I can't. I really can't argue that. Well, that's the thing, as far as I'm aware, Sega's changed it. To now at least look like Sonic. But in that shitty furry form. But yeah, I mean, I'm still not going to watch it. I'm not. Like, I don't need to see a bad movie to know it's a bad movie. I mean, unless someone I know pays me to go, then I'll go, but otherwise, I'm not going to watch it. Ah, Captain talking. There's the beautiful city of Alderaan. Shoop de whoop. Quick Dunnix. Time to see it. I mean, in all honesty, if someone did, I mean, I would then go and watch it. But otherwise, I'm not watching it anytime soon. I'm not. Like, never. Thank you. Like I say, I'm not opposed to it. I'm not. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I like Code Zero. If anyone bought anything, I mean, of course I'd fucking play it, but... because I own quite a lot of stuff. Kind of hard to go, oh, would you like this? I've already got it. Oh, I'd like to see you play this. I've already played it. Uh-huh. I would, honestly. I know you wouldn't fucking trust me, but... that's just your fault for not trusting me. I mean, there are some limitations, of course. R2, lovely. And then R2 again. Is he not going to spawn? Because I kind of can't cross this without Obi-Wan spawning to move that. I kind of can't play this level. I can't. Which means I'll have to restart the bloody level. Which will be slightly annoying. That should not happen. Now he's doing it. Okay, so I guess I had to sort of... I don't bloody know. Yeah, I can't do anything until the AI of Ben Kenobi walks across, kills all those Imperials to move the... bridge across. Well, in all honesty, I'm not an overly massive fan of Jim Carrey being Dr. Robotnik. But I mean, oh hey Brad, your childhood again compared to my child. I played this when it came out when I was a kid. I don't remember when it came out. I think it was 2000. I mean, because this is the complete saga, it's going to be younger than bollocks. It's going to be younger than the original versions, but yeah. Also, it's pretty funny how a lot of other games you say, oh shit, but then as soon as it gets to Lego, oh my god, it's Lego. Jim Carrey the movie. I really don't care, I'm not gonna go watch it. I'm not. Like I said, there are better things I can do with my time than watch a bad movie. Game is your childhood. Again, I'm older than you. Childhood equals nostalgia equals fire. Eh, not for me. Yeah, I really enjoy this game, but fucking hell is it broken. And obviously the problem is with nostalgia, it can blind you towards games that aren't probably that good. I mean, this is a good game. Admittedly, it could do with a little better polish, but because it's a very early sort of PC game, I sort of don't blame it. Really? It shouldn't be. Fuck, I need to go back outside, don't I? See, it's shit like this why this is sort of, oh god, annoying. Well, I mean, like I said, I was a kid when it came out. Not a kid years later and then played it. I was a wee lad. I do not remember how old, but bollocks. Yeah, like I say, it shouldn't be. Because I have it set to infinity. Which, last I checked, it's slightly longer than current. What do you mean, psh, Lego games? Listen, just because you was playing Ninja Gaiden when you was a kid, Black Blazer, you just play with Legos. I do have Lego, actually. Well, it shouldn't. And I can't really look into that at the moment because obviously I'm a little preoccupied. I'll have a look into it later. Never touched Ninja Gaiden. It's fine. I've played it. Yeah, it's a pretty hard game, but I wouldn't say it's that difficult. Because you have unlimited lives and unlimited continues, it's not that hard. I mean, besides the final level, you do have to get through the entire final level in one fell swoop, which is very hard. Yeah, that ninja guy, not the newer ones. No, I went to the right. Your NES days were limited to Mario, Excitebike, and Tiger Heli. Nice. I will admit, Excitebike, for the time, very good game, but yeah, it's a little on the iffy side. Also, how does someone who goes in first come out last? Also, we've taken off the clothes, it seems, for no particular reason. I like how the music gets all incredibly amazing and then 5 seconds later. Oh. What else did you play whilst growing up then? Besides Mario, Excitebike, and Tiger Heli. Never heard of Tiger Heli, but you know. I would assume. It's a top down kill everything, get a high score. It's a basic up scroll and chomp, yeah, like I said. That's why I said shoot everything, get the high score. No ending to it, you just play till you die. Oh, really? Okay. See, that's the thing, I would... Like, I really want to play NES, SNES, Mega Drive, Genesis, all these kind of games, but I don't have a way of bloody streaming them. Like, there is one way that I can think of, and I believe the device is called an OSSC. I don't think that they're ever made anymore, but I think you can still sort of find them here and there. I can't remember how much they are. I think they're like £100 to £200, and I really want one. Emulator. Yeah, I mean, I could emulate, but like I say, I would prefer to have the NES next to me, getting the game, slotting it in, flicking that power switch, getting the controller like this, and then just sitting there and just playing a game, rather than sort of sitting here with an Xbox controller, just going. You know, it sort of doesn't have that same feel to it. It doesn't, at least not to me anyway. I mean, there's nothing wrong with it, with emulating. It's just like I say, I would prefer to have the thing, you know, and experience it the actual way that, you know, people used to, instead of, like I say, just sort of sitting behind a computer desk going, oh, this game's shit, and then just not uninstalling, but, you know, not giving a shit that you've played it, whereas if you actually own a copy, you can sort of... I don't know, it's just the way I am. I prefer to have them that way. Scorpion. Borderlands 3 has a personalized loot. So there's no bickering over guns on multiplayer. Yeah, but that's if you play it multiplayer, and who the hell plays co-op games multiplayer? What are you, some kind of chump, Black Blazer? Or can you use OG controls emulator? Yeah, but... Again, you still don't get thought. You still don't get that feeling of having the console, plugging it in, slotting in the game. It doesn't work. That sort of thing. You know. You do. No. Well, you know. Fuck! Kill them, please! I know you can't, but... Fuck! You have personal friends who you play games with, so there's that now. I'll go back to my previous comment. What are you, some kind of chump? Who wants to buy Borderlands anyway? I mean, unless you want to play with friends, and that's alright, but because I don't have anyone I can play with, I'm not going to buy it. I mean, I already own Borderlands 1, 2, and the pre-sequel, but I've never played them. I've beaten Borderlands 1. You give me a good smacking. Thanks, man. Like I said, I don't have anyone that I can play with, so owning that game is pointless. I mean, I could still play them on my own, but and I will. But you fucker. Like I said, I need friends. Believe it or not. I mean, you will believe it, but... Eh, not all I can do. Play Banjo-Kazooie. I mean, Banjo-Kazooie is a good game, but... I do own it. For Nintendo 64 and Xbox One. Because I own Rare Replay. Well, duh, you believe it. Thanks, man. I love you too, Black Blazer. Even though I'm a tosser, thanks. Gotta maintain your balance, can't be too nice or you feel icky. Icky Vicky, I don't know that song. I mean, I should know it, because it's from Fairly Odd Parents, but I don't remember it. Fumpf. That song crossed your mind after you typed it. I don't remember it. I don't. If you're still here later, Black Blazer, when I finish, I'll play it for you. No, my pa don't sell Avon. I still can't do it, but yeah. I do know someone who does, but I don't think they do anymore. Frame rate. Ah, Yavin 4. Or Yavin IV. Boom. Something, something plans. Oh yeah, I've got things to do. Also, nice T-wings. Nice X-wings. Just let this one go, Daniel. Just let it be. Let it go, thanks. As long as, I'm not gonna go there. Because if I go there, someone will fucking do it. Where's our boy, Wedge Antilles? Fuck off. Let it be, like the song. Yeah, exactly. Let it be, let it be. I can't remember who sings that song. I can't. I know it's some really old song, but someone will tell me, and then I'll go, oh yeah. You tosser. The Beatles, really? Oh. I may be English, but I don't listen to the Beatles. I don't. Not because I don't want to. And not because their music's bad, but I don't know, I just choose not to. Also, if you let it go, Pokemon, well, Poketrainer, I'll just call you Poketrainer, that would be much shorter. But yeah, just let that go. I'm not going to get into a discussion about anything. I'm not. True Jedi, I know, right? And considering I live in England, being a Jedi is an actual religion. I mean, I don't know what kind of nutcases came up with that, but, you know. Now for the... Never mind, I'm dead. I was going to say now for the trench run, but apparently dying was more consistent. You will now follow me. I can't do his voice. I'm not Mustafa from The Lion King. Again, another movie I've never watched. Just to make this easier on myself. There we go. Slams desk. What? Lion King, what? How? Oh. I've never seen Lion King. First things first. Ow. Next thing. I'll just take that. That's my cheese in it, I don't know, right? You played Star Fox. Which Star Fox? Because there's many a Star Fox games. Fly away? Never mind. Aww. Out of all of that, one trooper survived. Not for long. Use the Force, Luke. Even though the targeting system would have been more than fine. But the reason they do it is because otherwise if he uses the targeting system, blah 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 blah. Whereas if he does the whole use the Force, it's more powerful. It brings his character further in as being a Jedi. Like I say, Poke Trainer, just leave it alone. Just leave it alone. No one cares. Well, there goes the Bohan spy. Press F for Chewie. Yeah, I know, right. Rest in peace, Peter Mayhew. Jar Jar. Dude was pretty tall. 7'2", I think. Score times two, I need 1.2 million studs. Misa players, Jar Jar. Misa be really annoying. Yeah, I think 7'2". Oh no, scout droids. Or recon droids, whatever. Dead droids. 7'2", yeah. I hope that's the sound it makes, just... Oh, Tauntaun! That's as you reckon. One, I wouldn't know. Two, I really wouldn't know. It's never been brought up, Daniel. It's never ever been brought up. Shadows of the Empire flashbacks. I have played Shadows of the Empire. Also, nice mustache. But I've played it. I don't think I've ever beaten it. Because if it's on Steam, which I think it is, like I say, I've beaten a lot of the Star Wars games I own on Steam. And I've played all of them. So, yeah, I think Shadows of the Empire, Dark Forces, Empire at War, I've played them, I've just never beaten them. Not because I don't want to, it's just I just never have. No, turn around. I won't mind playing it though. I know it's a very old game, and obviously not a lot of people would want to watch something like that. But the game's actually pretty decent. Yeah, I mean, it's not, by today's standards, it's not amazing, you know, but I like it. I mean, I'll probably get lost, but it's the same thing with Doom. I've never beaten Doom. The old one, anyway. I always used to play a few levels, but just never. I just never bothered to finish it. Couldn't bother going through 4 levels of shadows, really. I know I've definitely played Dark Forces. I can guarantee you that. He was 8. I mean, I don't blame you. Also, I remember playing this in Star Wars Battlefront. This was amazing. Oh, give me the bomb. Thank you. I need 1.25 million studs so I can get the x2 stud, and if I can get it by the end of this episode, that would be good. No, give me the power up, give me the power up, give me the power up, thank you. no, ATSTs. What will I do? Oh, I can't get him just yet. Oh, so he just teleported. Whatever. Oh no, more of them. See, now you'd think, obviously, in what happens in the movie, they lose half, obviously. But you'd think after everything I'm bloody well doing here, you'd think they wouldn't lose half. Just one man in a snow speeder. And some rope. Clearly you're defying the plot. I mean, yeah. Yes. But apparently not. I mean, I don't remember them being there. Also, I like the tiny little Lego man just... We escape Hoth. I will admit, as good as an episode, as good as a film as episode 5 is, I don't like it in the Lego game. I'm not a massive fan of it. Ooh la la. Anyone want some coffee? Or tea, perhaps? Or whatever these guys drink in this bloody galaxy? Hey, maybe they drink galaxy. Thank you. And also, obviously, I'll throw this out, since I may as well. Like I say, once I'm done with this, probably in a couple of days, if anyone has any ideas of what you want to see me play, just let me know. Like I say, once I'm done with this, I don't know what I'm doing. And no, it will not be another LEGO game. I mean, there is a game that I wouldn't mind playing, but I don't want to play it just yet. I'm not ready for it. Plus, I'll play it and everyone will go, what the fuck is this shit? You cunt. What game is that? Oh, hey, Dark Shadow. Of course you fucking turn up. Just as I mentioned. I won't mind playing this game, but no one's going to know what that is. And then, as if by magic, you've managed to go back in time 5 minutes, wake yourself up, and go, psst, me, wake up now. But no, Stubbs is a zombie. I won't mind playing that. I wouldn't. Only problem is I don't really know of a way of playing it because it's on Xbox. I can't stream Xbox games. And if it's not backwards compatible for Xbox 360, which I think it is, but if it's not, then I can't play it anyway. I can't. And the PC version is utter shite and it doesn't run on anything. So Xbox One compatible. I don't think it's Xbox One compatible. I will guarantee you it's not Xbox One compatible. ...360 maybe, and most likely, but Xbox One, I'm more than certain it isn't. Because there are very few Xbox One games, Xbox One games that run on Xbox One. Like I said, there are very few that do. Yeah, I would know otherwise. I would. But whilst you're at it, check the Xbox 360 backwards compatible list for... I know what I will do. I do know what I will do. This is the only way that I can feasibly think of doing this. Only problem is I do not know the keys. I'll cheat the system. Two players, baby. No. Because like I say, if it is, I won't mind playing it. It's not a long game, but it is a game that I absolutely love. It's stupid, but it's good stupid. Obviously, Dogshot, if you have anything that, you know, let me know and I'll think about it. So like I say, once I'm done with this, like I say, in a couple of days, I'll play whatever. I will. I was actually maybe thinking, if not that, maybe Wolfenstein The New Order. I won't mind giving that a go again. Company 1, all 3 Gears games, Shadow of the Damned. Oh yeah, Shadow of the Damned, I've still got that. Silent Hill Downpour. I don't have Silent Hill Downpour. I don't, sadly. And even if I did, I'd probably have it on 30 PS3 anyway, but... If Silent Hill Downpour is backwards compatible for Xbox One, I will probably get it for Xbox 360. Just because of that issue, the frame rate. But... yeah, if it's on Xbox One, I'll definitely get it on Xbox 360, I will. And I'll probably just get both of the next-gen games. Compatible games that aren't on PC already. Oh, okay. Best offers for some niche games. I mean, I've got them. Obviously, I've got them. Are these games to play, or are these on the backwards compatible list? Because if these are games to play, then obviously I can think about them. But if these are on the backwards compatibility list, obviously I've already got some niche on Steam. Playing on the compatible list. Oh, okay. Well, like I said, I've already got both Star Wars Force Unleashed games on there. Yeah, so like I said, I will definitely look into Silent Hill Downpour for Xbox 360. And I'm guessing Homecoming isn't on that list, is it? Because if Homecoming was, I would definitely get them both on 360. I mean, I may as well get them on 360 anyway, but you don't believe so? Okay. Like, I'm pretty certain it isn't. But, you know, it was just in case if it was. Because then I'll own every Silent Hill game except Shattered Memories. That'll be the only Silent Hill game I won't own. Not because I don't want to own it, but just because I haven't found a copy. I haven't. Homecoming is right enough, is alright enough, but stay away from that Steam version. No, 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 I know. To stay away from the Steam version. I know to stay away from the Steam version. I mean, unless if it was free, then I'd give it a go, but because it won't be free, I mean, I'll never play it on Steam. One time from fiction, don't even do much, really. QQ. What the hell are you QQing about, Black Blazer? It wasn't even her, it was Han. Or as one guy put it, Hans. Continue the story. And now we're in space again. Space. Oh no, it's rebellion transport ships. One's a pure guy who wouldn't dare touch royalty so inappropriately. Okay. Whatever you say, Mom. Now, if I remember correctly, the red brick is around here somewhere. I don't remember where, but I know it's here. Or it's slightly later on. No, I want to say it's over there. Yeah, it is over there. Give me that bloody red brick. Give me the... There it is. See, I sort of remember the space sections like the back of my hand for some reason. And the red brick's obviously the most important, but I can't remember where the times 4 brick is. I'm pretty certain the time studs are on these levels. I mean, they didn't know that, but whatever. And also, Dark Shadow, you know the other day when we was talking about obviously like PlayStation exclusives and stuff and what to get, and obviously we talked about Heavenly Sword. I also found a game that I had once owned, completely forgot existed, called Lair, which was a launch title for the PS3. It's a really shitty... Well, it's not shitty, it's only shitty because you have to use the 6-axis motion controls to play the damn game. And it's, yeah, the 6-axis game. I'm glad you know of it. Because you mentioned Lair, what game? The one that you're forced to use the motion controls in. Oh, that game. Yeah, I've got that game. It was like 50p, so I thought, fuck it, I'll buy it. They also have Hayes and Heavenly Sword, but I just didn't bother picking them up for no particular reason. I'll probably get them when I'm uptown next, which might be tomorrow. And then the other games that I still don't own is like Little Big Planet, and then after that I really don't know what else I don't own. Oh yeah, 99 Nights 2, that's one. There's not on the Halo Kill. Yeah, Haze, I know. I've played it and I've beaten it. It's not good. let me just put that out there. It's not good. It's alright. Like I say, it's okay. It's not bad. But it's not great. About Killzone. I own them all. Except I don't own. I do own Killzone on PSP actually. But no, that's the only thing I don't, is I don't own Killzone 1 on PS3, because getting a physical copy is. I mean, because I can order it at CEX, which I probably will do. But obviously, finding a copy is not easy, because I don't think it was pretty much ever released here. Like, it was, but I think in very, very small quantities. Or in the Killzone Trilogy pack that they released. That's like the only way that you can find it, really. But yeah, I'll also look into that as well. Because then the only other Killzone game I don't own is the one on PS Vita. I don't kind of have a PS Vita. So, I still won't mind one, you know, just to at least get Uncharted, but, you know, well, that's the only game that I want it for. And is a PS Vita really worth it for one game? No, but if I ever did go down the route in the future, I mean, since you know me, I would force myself to get all, like, the PS Vita exclusives that I'm interested in, and if it came to, I'd just get them all anyway. Like the shitty COD, Call of Duty Black Ops Declassified, that lasts for all of about an hour. Not anything that comes up for video now, it has been a long time. Where what's come out? Oh, visual novels, VNs. But yeah, like I say, I know there's a few games to get, and like they're all dirt cheap. So like I say, if I went down that route, which like I say I would have done, because Tesco was like getting rid of their PS Vitas for like £50 a pop, and I thought to myself, if our local Tesco has one, I'll get one, a brand new PS Vita for 50 quid. If I don't want it, I can always sell it anyway and get my money back. So, but yeah. So like I say, if I do go down the route, I will research every game that has ever been released for that thing, because it wouldn't take me long. And then I can actually go, okay, well that's on multiple consoles, that's exclusive, it would cost me about £80 to buy the console, and then, what, £50 or less to get all the games for it? So it'd be £130 and I would own the entire, library of games you'd ever own for it. And like I say, there'd be Uncharted, Killzone, I don't think there was a Resistance game, Call of Duty Black Ops Declassified. I wouldn't mind getting Wipeout, but because that's on the Wipeout Omega collection on PS4, there'd be no rush. And then there's games like Dungeon Hunter, which is mediocre. And then, like I say, no other game comes to mind for the PS Vita. But like I say, that's because I haven't researched it. And like I said, I don't really know of any games for it. Then there's that weird deception game where you play as like the devil's daughter. And it's like a sort of a turn-based game where you set traps to kill people. I know there's a couple of them on PS4, but I don't know if the one that was on PS Vita was ported to PS4. I want to say it was. Persona 4 Golden, since I was just too fucking lazy to port it. Well, yeah, I couldn't do. But is Persona 4 Golden an actual fully featured game, or is it like the bloody PSP game and it's all fucking manga cutscenes and not full-fledged? Because if it's a full, if it's just a fully-fledged Persona game on Vita, I mean, I'll get it on Vita. I'll play it. I mean, it'll pretty much be impossible for me to stream it, because pretty much the only way to stream Vita games is through a camera. So I would have to get somehow a way to obviously set up a really shitty cam, well, not a shitty camera, but get like this camera and set it up, or buy a new one in the future and set one up to film Vita games. It's the full game, but with a bunch of expanded content, pretty much like what P5R Royal is now. Ah, okay. Like I say, that'd obviously be a game to look into then. Like I say, that's way further down the road. Like, I'm nowhere near thinking about getting a Vita. Like I say, I only was because, I mean, 50 quid for a Vita. I mean, it's steel. But as soon as that went live, like, pretty much anyone who knew about it went to all the Tesco's and bought them. So like I say, owning a copy was not easy. Well, you want to look into a PSTV for shit you want to stream? I don't know how PSTV works, but I know the app plug thing is pretty cheap, but like I said, I would have to look into it. Like I said, I would look into how to stream PS Vita games. You know, and then obviously I can play them. It's the same thing with PSP, but I've got the cable to do it. It's just that the fucking HDMI adapter's shit, and pretty much all HDMI adapters are shit. That's why, like I mentioned earlier, I wouldn't mind getting a OSSC or OSCC. I did note it down. OSSC. If you don't mind Dark Shadow, just Google OSSC. I know you can't buy them anymore. Or at least not, you know, like retail and stuff. I know you can't buy them anymore, but I think people are flogging them for like 150 quid. But if they're like 150 quid, and like I say, if they can stream like all the old, you know, like NES, Sega Genesis, you know, all those consoles, and I can obviously start doing Nintendo 64, some PSP games, you know, that kind of stuff, you know. And I know £150 is a lot of money just for like two consoles, but then, like I've mentioned before, I could then actually get into buying, you know, NESs, SNESs, you know, that kind of stuff, instead of emulating it, because, you know, I'm not a massive fan of emulation. And, you know, like I say, actually having the console sitting next to you playing on it is, I don't know, it just feels better. There's just something to it. It just feels better. It does. Prices around 140-170 pounds. Yeah, like I say, it's not cheap, but like I say, for someone of my aspect who would be playing obviously a lot of, you know, old consoles and stuff, I mean, the price tag is not that bad, all things considered, because it is supposed to be like the go-to recording device for, you know, RCA input devices. And if it is, again, I would just need to look into it again, but if it is just plug and play, you know, plug everything, connect everything, and then play, I mean, I won't mind. again, that would be in the future thing, but yeah, I won't mind it. And is that like on eBay or Amazon and stuff like that? Yeah, what, eBay or Amazon? Because Amazon, I mean, even though it won't be by the company, but like I say, I won't mind it. But it's just so I can mostly play. One thing. Yeah, it's just so I can mostly play. Oh, I did this the wrong way around. No! What the fuck? Because, like I said, I won't mind playing PSP games. Because there are a lot of PSP games that are very fun and enjoyable. I mean, for what the console is, they had sort of no right being that good, but, you know. And then, obviously, the only other thing to invest in is, obviously, a DS. And, sending a DS off to get fitted with a capture card inside. Or HDMI connector thing. Because then, like I said, there are a lot of DS and 3DS games to play. Fuck, I need R2. Like I say, it becomes a very expensive hobby when you get someone like me. Because you have an interest in so many games. And you know, there are a lot of games that obviously you want to stream and stuff. It's, like I say, it becomes very expensive very quickly. So obviously if I wanted to do all that right now, obviously that's say 150 for that, then for a 3DS, well obviously a 3DS will cost you about 100, so that's 250, and then a capture card also runs you about 200 quid, because like I say, people don't really do them anymore. So like I say, you're looking at around like 400 fucking quid just to get that shit started. I guess I played any good shit, even the COD games, they crapped out with a bunch of hamburgers and fries. Yeah, no, I've played them. They are obviously not good compared to, obviously, the, you know, console counterpart. But for what they were, they were better than they had any right to be. They did. And also, because you have the gimmicky touchscreen with the DS, like, if I remember correctly, I think it was in COD World at War, on DS, where you have to like defuse bombs or plant bombs and stuff to blow your way forward, and obviously doing stuff like that on the DS, at least in my aspect, gives it a nice, you know, it makes the DS not be gimmicky like the Wii felt after a while. Because when the Wii came out, the Wii was fun and enjoyable because it was like, oh, motion control's nice. But then as years went on, the Wii sort of just became very gimmicky and it was sort of eh. But I will admit, obviously, the games sort of got better. Not really, but sort of got better as time went on. And obviously, like I say, on DS, you have the two Zelda games, and I would really love to play them, I would. Because they are very, very good games. RE1 DS did the same for touch screen puzzles. That purist has the option to play without. Oh, yeah. Do you remember me playing Resident Evil 1 on DS? Back in maths class in school. Because I remember getting about halfway through. I do. I remember getting about halfway through. You remember specific room two? Yeah, Mr. Burns' classroom. And also, was you there when I beat, when I beat Kirby? Well, Kirby Mouse Attack. There's the U-turn room and the stairs going down. Yeah. Like I say, it was, no, you wasn't. Oh, damn. But yeah, I remember being in there. Like, I was... This was weird, obviously. Being the cool kid, you're in maths class. Well, not maths class, but you're in, like, the maths lunch club thing. But because it was my teacher, he let me stay in there. He did. He, because I usually had maths afterwards, or sometimes I didn't, he just said, you can stay if you want. As long as you don't mess the room up. But if you do, you clean it. Pretty cool teacher. I liked him. But, yeah, I remember sitting in the corner just on my DS, and some people were like, oh, what you playing? And it's like, oh, I'm on the final boss of Kirby Mouse Attack. And then my heart was pumping because I literally had, like, pixel health when I beat him. And like, people are there gathering around you like, oh my god, oh my god. And you pull off the move. Because if I remember correctly, what I did is I was at no health and I thought, fuck, I'm gonna die. So I just thought I'd spit out. Because when you get hit, like, stars spawn. So I thought I'd suck it in, spit it back out again. And then I believe he flew backwards to... I think he was dodging an attack at the time because he hit me, and then I went for him and he dodged back. Because I picked up the star, threw it back at him. And then just as he landed, I hit him and caused the last blow. It was amazing. It was. Like, that's when you know you're not the cool kid, but you are the cool kid. You know, you're bringing in DSs, beating very hard. Well, not very hard, but beating pretty difficult bosses. And people are going, oh my god, you're amazing. Those were the days. Bollocks. Now, I'm doing this. But like I say, there's a shit ton of DS games I'd love to play. Like I say, the two Zelda games, they would probably be first on my list. Because those games are very good. They are. Actually, what else do I have? Just before I continue onwards. I have the Assassin's Creed game, that's good. I've got two... Combat of Giants games. I need the third one. They're all the exact same game. Drawn to Life. I've got all of them. New Super Mario Brothers. Ninja Gaiden. Now, that would be a game I'd love to play. Prince of Persia. That's another one. And I've got three of the four Professor Layton games. I think RCEX has the other one. And if they do, I'll get it. Because I think the last one I'm missing is Pandora's Box. Which is the only game that I need. And then, obviously, if and when that ever came to, you guys could go, do you not know the answer to this puzzle as you're Googling the answer? Or I'm just sitting there going, but what is 2 plus 2? How do you figure 2 plus 2 out? What? And you guys are just sitting there going, oh my fucking God, Jesus Christ. I don't care about the audience. It's been a fucking while since you felt engaged with any... final nowadays. Well, I mean, you know, it's because we have all the time in the world now. Whereas back then, when you have, I think, for me anyway, like, when you have these final fights, like, if you die within, like, half a second, you know, oh, this is a difficult boss fight, and it's gonna take me a while, whatever. You know, whereas when you're a kid, like, when you have something that's difficult, at least in my aspect, when you have something that's difficult, and you manage to surpass it, whether people are watching or not, you get that immediate gratifying feeling of your heart's racing, the adrenaline's gone through the roof. Whereas, like I say, nowadays, it's just sort of, if something's hard, I just sort of, oh, I can't do this, I'll come back to this later, because I know I'm gonna get pissed and I'm not gonna be able to beat it, you know. So I think that's for me, anyway. But then again, that's the thing, is like, it's like, say, like, Sekiro. I know that it's a hard game. I could play it and find it really easy and go, what the hell, it's not that hard. You know? Or I'll play it and it'll be very hard. Oh, no, I need to go back a bit, don't I? Or it'll be very hard and you get to the final boss and it's, oh my god, oh my god. But I don't know, I just don't really feel that way anymore. Oh no, if I remember correctly, I need Bloody Yoda, don't I? Yeah, I do need Yoda. It's just the final boss is nowadays the easiest to kill. Final boss will be excellent, probably. But yeah, but like I say, even though, like, yes, okay, I will admit, final bosses are usually easy. But, like I say, with a game like Sekiro, you know it's a hard game. So you know if you play it, if it's pretty challenging as you're playing the game, you know how challenging it's going to be. So when you get to the final boss, they're either going to be as easy as difficult or more difficult than as you've been playing the game. So, like I say, to me, it's like with Dark Souls, like, I know what I'm getting into when you play these games. So, like I say, you get to the final boss and you try it a few times, and if you're just dying over and over again, it's too... just ignore it, turn it off, come back to it another day, and play it tomorrow or something, instead of sitting there hour after hour, just grinding them out, hoping you beat them, you know? Dark Souls 3. I really kept you trying again and again, seeing the boss change form and have so many damage attacks and changing yourself up, so you have to keep yourself up yourself. Just like so. Yeah, I will admit, yeah, the final boss in Dark Souls 3, I will admit, it's probably one of the best boss fights in the Souls games. I'm not going to say Soulsborne, because that's a whole different subject. But in the Souls games, I will admit, he's probably one of the better, if not one of the best, bosses that the games have to offer. Because he's not cheap. Okay, he does have some moves that are a little... stupid, like the one move where he lifts up his sword and stabs it, and then it does that massive explosion. Like, that's a little cheap, because you just don't know how far... Can I make this? I don't think I can. But you just don't know how far the attack will hit, or what the sort of attack will be. So, like I say, it does feel a little cheap at first. But then, thankfully, after that, because when you know it's coming, it's a very easy attack to dodge. And it's like I've mentioned before, with difficulty in video games, you have to expect the player... Well, you don't have to expect the player, but you have to sort of allow the player to beat, say, Dark Souls or something, first try, without taking any hits, never played a video game before in your life, you know... I mean, it's never going to happen, but you have to sort of assume it's going to happen. So, like I say, with a game like Dark Souls, yes, it might be hard, but... I don't know, like, when I played 3, like I say, the only guy that I could just never beat was the Nameless King. He could go fuck himself. He can. I hate him as a boss. I don't mind his natural form after the dragon, but his dragon form is just... stupid and sort of unfair. Whereas then, like I say, you fight the final boss and he's just a lot more fair. You can beat him first try, you know, like I almost did. Granted, I sort of knew what was going to happen. I mean, it had been a few years since I'd seen you attempt it, but I mean, it still wasn't that bad. And then I made it easier on myself, because I didn't beat him first try. And then I decided to summon the two people you get for doing the... like, undead ending, or whatever the hell it is. Lord of Hollow ending, yeah, that ending. Because I accidentally got it. I did. I accidentally got it. Oh yeah, I need to do this, don't I? So like I said, I did all of the dying and then get the free upgrades and stuff. And then I was talking to someone and I did a few other things. And then that's when I think you told me about that ending. So I decided to look it up and I went, oh shit. I've done a lot of these steps. I'll get this ending whilst I'm at it. Oh wow, speedrun tech. when you play Wolfenstein. Can you tell me about Wolf 2 when you get to it? Oh, well, it probably won't be anytime soon, because, like I say, if I do play Wolfenstein, I probably won't play Wolfenstein 2 until, like, way after. Then again, depending on how I feel, I might play it straight afterwards, and then I'll probably nick the old blood from you. Because I don't own the old blood. But I'll probably wait to play Wolfenstein 2 until, say, after the Steam sale. Because I wouldn't mind getting the Season Pass. Because if I can get the Season Pass pretty cheap, I'll get it. I'm playing that last time you did all the Wolf 3D levels, really. Oh, I guess for skipping forward blood. Oh, okay. It's just about a 3 to 4 hour game. Yeah, I know it's not long. It's just that I've recently watched Blood Thunder. At GDQ, I believe. Speedrun, the old blood, and Wolfenstein, and a few other games. Actually, he's a pretty decent speedrunner and a pretty decent commentator. The Darkness one. Oh my god, I forgot that game exists. I think I own it. I'm pretty certain I don't. But I have beaten it. The Darkness one, I don't know. I really like both games. But there's something about... Okay, so the Darkness 2 plays better. But there's something about the Darkness one that I like slightly more than the Darkness 2. Yeah, like I say, Darkness 2 has way better gameplay, because it almost turns it generic into its gameplay, which is fine. You know, it almost turns into a generic shooter. But, like I say, there's just something about the Darkness 1 that I do like. I can't put my finger on it, I will have to replay it. But, actually, I'm pretty certain I don't own it. No, I don't. Because it's not on my list. It's not. It's not. There's a better story and atmosphere. Yeah. I will admit, that's the one thing that it does have going for it. I am your father. No. I am. See, this is another thing. People think that he says, "Look, I am your father." No, no, I am your father. Because, I mean, who else would he be bloody talking to? Well, that's episode 5. No, it isn't. One more level. Oh, yeah. The cryogenic scene. Maybe what race is different depending on which race of the movie people are watching. No, it doesn't. As far as I'm aware, it's always, "No, I'm your father." They never redubbed it, as far as I'm aware. It's just one of those things that people always used to say, "Luke, I'm your father." Because when we say it, people then get the reference. Whereas if we say, "No, I'm your father," getting the reference would be a little misleading. I mean, yeah, Star Wars nerds would get it. But by saying, "Luke, I'm your father," it then immediately becomes a pop culture reference, sort of. Also, there's Boba Fett, the most useless bounty hunter in the galaxy. Lando Calrissian. Come here, Lando. Could you fuck off? You. No, we don't have R2 no more. Bye, Han. I'll see you in the next movie. Note to self, don't shoot random people. Or random Cloudians? I really don't know what you call them. So I think we're on Bespin. We live in the Cloud City. Well, it is a Cloud City, but I think Bespin is the planet. I don't know. Could you please, if you don't mind, Lando, in this universe, thank you. A nice swimsuit. I've mentioned that before, but I do like the random chance that a clone will spawn in like his underwear or something. Come on, R2. Bombs. Oh, me tush. Come on. Thank you. Come on, Lando. Why does it always have to be a double locked by R2? Also, after this, I want to know how many studs I have total, because like I say, I need 1.25 million to get the x2 stud. There he is, in his swimming trunks. Who would ever walk out into battle unarmed? Also a nice black eye. Black eye, I should say. Ooh, 969,000. I need, what, another pretty much 55. If I replay the trench run, I could get that in studs. Also, I like that little JPEG of the galaxy right in the middle. That's episode 5, and I'll probably leave it here, because it is 8 o'clock. Oh my god, I thought I had the time to beat all 3 episodes. Oh well, I'll have a quick look-see to see what else in red bricks I have. See, if I also have the x4, nice, because then once I get those two, whatever you need. Oh, Commander Cody. Hey, man, how you doing? I also do that. No, I mean, so that was... You kind of like the JPEG background images. I mean, I don't mind them. I'm not saying it's shit, but, you know, just pointing it out. So, which one was it again? No. No. 3. So it was 5-3 that I got that in. 5-3, I think it's 6-1. 5-3, 5-4, 5-5. 5-6. No, it's in 5-6. Because then 6-1, 6-2, 6-3, 6-4, 6-5, 6-6. Was it 6-1, 6-2? 6-3 and 6-6. I think I know where it is, but I just can't get it at the moment. And then, what was it? 6-3. If 6-3 is an auto level, which I don't think it is, that one isn't, because that's the Battle of Endor, the moon planet event of Endor. Especially if you can count the pixels on them. Oh, well, I mean, that's the best. That's always the best. Now, how much is times 4? 2.5. It is double. But then all I need... I mean, power brick detector would be nice. Which one is it? Minikit detector is 5-5. So 5-5 is the minikit detector. That's the only one, the one that I need. I just need times 2, minikit detector, and power brick detector. Excuse me. And then also character studs would be nice, and then also magnetized studs. But otherwise, I just need those three. So I have 125. 125, 1.5. Not how much that is, I guess a million. So what, 2.5 million I need to get all the ones that I want. Oh, and then you can buy gold bricks. And there are 14 of them. Yes, like I say, that's the plan for that tomorrow. So yeah, like I say, that's the plan. If I don't quite have the studs tomorrow, I will replay that trench run level, because you can get like 70,000 on that like that. So I can do that. Get the money for times 2. Probably replay it just so I can get the 1.1. No, I need... Yeah, so I need to play it probably once, maybe twice. Get the power brick detector. Play the level that has the minikit detector power brick in. Get that. Because I need a bounty hunter. That's the only other thing that I think that I need. And Zam Wessel is a bounty hunter. Because you have small character, jumping character, Jedi, Sith. I've got Sith. Obviously, you have the droids, stormtroopers, but I think bounty hunters also work. I don't think there's anything else that I need. Fuck it, I'll just get Jango Fett now because he's a bounty hunter and he will work. And then fuck it, also get the stormtrooper. That should unlock everything. That should be for everything from tomorrow. So like I say, I'll beat episode 6, get the times 2 brick, get that. Do that. And then I can just play every level from beginning to end again. Except get everything. Then there's the Jabba the Hutt missions, which take like 2 seconds if you know where everyone is. And yeah, I don't really think there's anything besides that. I will also play the Lego Indiana Jones trailer, because by doing that you unlock Lego Indiana Jones as a character for free. So I'll do that tomorrow. But yeah, anyway, thank you for coming along. I appreciate it as always. But yeah, more Lego Star Wars tomorrow. Then probably after that, like I say, probably be Wolfenstein. But anyway, without further ado, thank you for coming along. I appreciate it. What's that with you? Supposed to be Anakin. You are. Why are you still the same size? Okay, anyway. Like I said, I'll be off. I'll catch you again tomorrow. Also, I'll probably continue talking to you anyway, Dark Shadow. Like I say, I'll be off. I'll catch you again tomorrow. So have a good evening and good night.